Hello and welcome to Medmont's M700 tutorial videos. In this series of tutorials, I'll be showing you around the perimetry side of Medmont's studio and how to use your M700. In this video, I'll be discussing the basics of starting an M700 test. First, we'll look at how to set up your M700, and then I'll move into the essentials of the testing window. To start with, you're going to want to open up your copy of Medmont Studio and ensure that your perimeter is plugged in and turned on. All you need to do is connect the power cable, the USB cable, and the patient switch, and your perimeter is ready to go. If you haven't installed Medmont Studio yet, please read the quick install guide which was included with your M700 for help. If you have Medmont Studio installed from a previous install, you can go to the top right corner and press Help, and then About Medmont Studio. Here, you'll be able to see the components that you have installed. For example, on this computer I have our DV2000 imaging software, an E300 topographer, and an M700 perimeter installed. You can also access all of the user menus for your installed Medmont instruments from this help menu. If you don't have an M700 installed, you're going to want to open the Medmont Studio configuration tool, which can be found in your programs list, and reinstall Medmont Studio with the M700 component selected. If you haven't installed the calibration file yet, this is the first thing you need to do. Go into the Configure tab up here, press Instrument Setup under M700, and press the Import button. From here, you can browse the calibration file found on the USB key provided with your M700. Double-click on the calibration file folder, select the calibration file, and press OK. From this window, you have a variety of options. If you have more than one perimeter installed, you can select one and set it as your default perimeter. With a default instrument selected, when you start an exam, the test window will open with the selected instrument. However, if you're using a perimeter other than your default, you can return to this window and unset the default, which allows you to select the perimeter to use at the beginning of each test. If you haven't installed the perimeter yet and want to use the simulator, you can install it the same way. Just press Import and browse to wherever you've stored the simulator file. I'm going to close this down now and move on. To begin a test, return to the Home menu and look in the New Exam panel. If there is an option for a perimetry exam, then you've successfully installed the M700 component of Medmont Studio. If you're using the bowl simulator, please select the pre-existing exam for the simulator to work with. You can download both the simulator and a package of sample data from the support page of the Medmont website. The link to that page is in the comments of this video. Once downloaded, simply press File, Import, and browse to the sample data to import it. When you're ready, press the Perimetry Exam button. This gives you the option to select from any perimeters you have installed. If you already selected a default, this window will be skipped and the Perimetry Exam window will open immediately. I'm going to select the perimeter I have attached and press OK. Now that we've opened the perimeter test window, we're ready to start an exam. This window is separate from Medmont Studio, so if you close it, Medmont Studio will still be running in the background. This is the main test window, and all the essential features for running an exam can be accessed from here. If you had a patient selected when you started the test window, their name will be displayed in the top window. You can clear this name out by pressing the Clear button in the Patient section of the ribbon bar. You can also select a different patient by pressing Select and either typing in a name or choosing a patient from the list. An important feature, if you're quickly screening patients and you don't necessarily need the test associated with the patient, is that you can leave the patient field blank and still run a test. However, if you want to save the exam, you will have to choose a patient at the end. To get started with the test, the first thing you need to do is select the test template you want to use. Click on this drop-down list, and you'll see all of the built-in test templates. I'm going to do a quick test using the Central 22 test template. Make sure you have the correct eye selected, and have chosen the type of fixation monitoring you want to use. For this test, I will use video fixation monitoring. When the patient is ready, all you need to do is press the Start button, and the test will begin. You can pause the test at any time by pressing the Pause button, and then start it again using the Start button. The patient can also pause the test by holding down the patient switch. Notice that in the top left there is a test status indicator, which displays that it is currently patient paused. Once the patient releases the patient switch, the test returns to running. You can also stop the test at any time by pressing the stop button. Once the test is stopped, you have the option to start a new test, save the test, or analyze it immediately. Since this wasn't a real test, there's very little data to display. Making sure you have enough data is an important point to consider when you decide to stop a test early, and it's not recommended. As I mentioned earlier, to save a test, I must select the patient first. Okay, this concludes the first video in our M700 Perimetry Essentials series. Thanks for joining me, and I hope to see you in the next video.